In this video, we're going to replace this two gang dimmer here for one that looks virtually the same, but hopefully will work correctly. Marcus has already looked at two gang switches in a previous video, and I'll leave a link for that in the eye above my head. We're also going to look at what the wiring method is here, the cable colours, and then obviously reconnect the new dimmer. But why am I replacing the dimmer? It hasn't failed, but I had a bright idea for my mum to change her lamps in her living area from old incandescent ones, because the amount of wattage she was using on those lights was horrendous. So I did the good thing. I went out and bought some LED ones. However, the old resistive dimmer doesn't quite work. When you dim it down, you get a nice flickering of those lights, and it's not a flicker that feels like a warm candle. It's one that feels quite annoying when you're sitting watching the telly. So doing the good deed in the first place to replace them for LED lamps has now given me another good deed. I've got to replace the dimmer with one that's designed to dim LED lights. Now, I could go into lots of details about dimming LEDs, but I've done that on my other YouTube channel, eFix, in the Great British Dim Off. So in the description, I'll leave a link for some of those videos so you can get a little bit more understanding about leading and trailing edge dimming. So we're going to replace this dimmer today. The full safe isolation process has been carried out, so we're ready to do the change over the dimmer. But we're going to work out first of all how the lighting circuit's been wired, and hopefully from all the videos I've done on the two and three plate method, you can start identifying what we've got here. So I'll just give you a second to look at what we've got in here in order that you can work it out. Hopefully the connector block at the back there, which are black conductors, which is pre-2004's colour for neutral, going to a connector there. So this has taken the feed directly to the switch. So we've got a cable coming in with the permanent line connection, which is probably this one here, because it's also got this bridging link that Marcus talked about as well, which we're going to have to use again. So that brings in your permanent line, a neutral and a circuit protective conductor as we feed the switch. And then we've got a couple of switching line conductors going out for the two lights in this area, along with two neutrals and two CPCs. So we've used taking the feed to the switch in this method. And I'm just going to whip out the conductors and have a look at those and make off the new dimmer. So this is the permanent line connection, and it's got that bridging link as well, which we're probably going to need in the next one. So we're going to keep that as well. So we bring that one out, and that's my permanent line connection. Now, it could be that you want to mark or identify that as your permanent line, or you might just want to fold it out of the way. So that's my feed into my common, and it's going to have to remain into my common in the new system. And I've got two switching conductors coming out for each of the lights, and they're coming out probably what they'll class as L1. I'll get my screwdriver in here, just undo that one. So that's a switching line connection, and over here we've got another one. So if I leave them at the bottom, we can see what we've got there. So drop those out. I'm going to take my link out as well, in case I need that moving forward. This dimmer's been on the wall for 15 years, and I've spent about 5 minutes at it. I've nearly wrecked it. So there's my little bridging link. So we've got our two switching line conductors going out for the lights in the dining and living area, and my permanent line coming in, which will again go into the common connection of my new dimmer. So on the back of my new two gang dimmer, we've got exactly the same arrangement as we're comfortable with seeing. We've got common L1 and L2 on both. Permanent line is going to come into common. We're going to use that bridging link to come across to the other common. And our switching line conductor comes out of L1 on both of these dimmers. So let's make those connections then. Just going to back off the screws. I'll start with a common. I'm going to wind that quite a way back. It might be a case now of judging whether you think the terminations here can be screwed into again. So if we look at one of our switching line conductors, it's quite fragmented. So I'm probably going to remake off the ends of these conductors again. We've seen that on the channel, so I'll just cut away. I'll remake off the ends in order that we haven't got that dented copper that could be a weak area and break when I screw back into it. And then my two switching lines, ready for the connections. And they're better than what we had before. Still got plenty of length. That's the beauty of making sure your conductor are a reasonable length when you do it the first time round. You can terminate them again, but they're still great length. So we've got our commons and our L1s. It's not a two-way dimmer, so we'd have the L2 if we were two-way. Opening up those terminals, don't want them to drop on the floor. Hopefully they're captive. So there we go. So let's drop our common into one. We can see the depth. Got to try and make that bridging link go in there as well. So I'll bring my bridging link in. Into there, which is doubled over. And then my connection, so that goes into common. So we're going to bring the permanent line into common and loop across to the other common. Tighten that one off. Firm. A little tug. We're happy with that. And just bring the common into the next one. So looped across there. Tighten that one up, and it's just a case then of connecting in my two switching lines into L1 and L1. If they're the wrong way round, we've got a choice. We can either rotate the dimmer or we can just swap them over. So we've got them front to back. They were not necessarily that logical last time. So open that one up, pop it in. That's one of my switching line conductors done. Nice and firm. And then we do the second one into L1. And that's my new two gang dimmer connected. And hopefully, because this has been designed to work with LEDs, that we'll lose that flickering that we had previously on the old resistive type one. Sometimes you can get away with it. And obviously in this case, I couldn't. I'm trying to do a good deed. So that's in. Just give them a little tug. And then I tend to like to push them back into location and then just lean them forward before obviously screwing it back into place. I'm probably going to change this as well. Just one thing to bear in mind, obviously I knew this was a deep box because it already had a dimmer on from new. Notice the depth of these. These wouldn't fit on a normal 16mm chased-in box. You're going to need 25mm at least in order to fit a dimmer on. So if for some reason you say to your parents, oh, I can change that switch over for a dimmer, it's worth checking first of all the box is deep enough in the wall before you promise that you can fit one in there. But that's a straight changeover. Just needs screwing back now and that's it finished. And we'll check to see if the new dimmer removes the flicker that we had with the previous one. So by removing the old resistive dimmer and installing one that's designed to dim LED lights, we've got rid of the flicker that we had before, so that's a happy mum for me. If you want to know how I did the safe isolation procedure before carrying out the changing of the dimmer switch, check out the video just here.